Good afternoon, everybody. So what I'm going to talk about today is the disruption in real estate that no broker is trying to bring. So I'll talk about the market size, I'll talk about the customer pain points and the solution and how technology is trying to basically help disrupt this big market. So the real estate is basically one of the basic necessities. In fact, many of the innovations which are happening here, which are discussing in this platform also, are basically from this gamut. So that's a given. But now the question is as to what is the pain point when it comes to the real estate. So when we look at the entire real estate transaction, the way which it happens is, so I'm sure most of you have either rented out a house or you have, so you either own a house which you have rented out or you are a tenant who is living in a rented house. And you would agree with me that brokers typically don't budge, and especially in Bombay, they make sure that they take 1 month brokerage from both the sides. So a 2 month brokerage is what a common man pays, both owner and tenant combined, for a typical 11 month contract. So 2 by 11 is like 18%. 18% is such a high intermediation cost, which is unheard of in most of the industries. If you look across, most of the industries in the past few years have been disintermediated, and the cost have fallen down significantly. This is one of the only industries which is now remaining, which has such a high intermediation cost. So what does a broker do? He basically takes the key, he shows a couple of flats, he has a conflict of interest because for him what is more important is not a efficient matchmaking, but basically doing a deal which is fast, so that he can make his own brokerage. He uses very limited technology for advice, he has a limited network which he uses, and he wants to quickly close the deal. So what has happened in the past few years, if you see this entire real estate gamut, is that many of the players like Housing Common for 9-10 acres, Magic Bricks, they have brought a tad of efficiency in the overall transaction. So what has happened is that the span of matchmaking has increased. But if you look at from the customer point of view, so what has happened well is that customer is able to see properties in terms of good maps, good photos, all that has happened. So you want to take a property, you can go to a site and you can see a lot of properties with good maps. But if you do the entire transaction, will you save any penny? Most probably not. So majority of the transactions which basically happen through the sites which brokers are using. So most of the sites work with the brokers, not without the brokers. So what happens is that eventually the transaction gets concluded through a broker and you have to pay this 9% each. So when we looked at it, we thought, okay, so this is an industry which still has such a high transaction cost. So let's look at from a different perspective, what are the key customer pain points that we have. So the two key pain points is that when you are looking, say for example, a flat in Bandra, you would want to go to a site which shows you a list of all the flats with the right information. There are many sites wherein many of you who have tried to find a house will basically agree that the broker keeps on repeating the same flat again and again. Many of the flats which have good photos, they will perpetually be there, they will never be removed. And the moment you reach out to a broker and you meet him, you'll say, that property has gone in the morning, I'll do something else. And for the same flat in Malar, whose true value is 30,000 bucks, he will put two properties, one for 35,000, another for 35,000. One is to entice owners and another is to entice tenants. And if you ever try to post your property on any of these sites, you'll quickly discover that even if you write in capital letters that no broker please, still the brokers will call you and they will quickly copy your ad, your photos or all the other sites. They will start getting calls from tenants and they will in turn call you and say, I have more tenants for you. So what has happened is that owners haven't found much of incentive to go to these sites and use their own properties because they feel that finally I'm going to get calls from brokers, so it's better to just cross the street and give it to the broker whom I actually know. So coming to the tenant side, the problem that a tenant faces is that a lot of information is wrong, is not verified. Some sites like housing.com have taken the effort, but at a high cost, they were able to verify properties, click photos and post it. But the second problem, which is about the high cost of transaction, that is unsolved. As a customer, if you try to rent out or rent a property, majority of the cases, by majority I mean more than 90%, you will hit up paying a brokerage. So basically, we tried to see whether we can come up with a solution which can disrupt this market. And what we saw is, so as of now, no broker, when you compare it across players, be it horizontal classifieds or vertical classifieds, the inconvenience, which is wrong information, has been at a good level solved by housing.com, but not by other sites. This is something that we do because no broker is a platform which connects owners and tenants directly with each other with no intermediary in between using the help of technology. Second is the high cost transaction, which is a problem that a customer faces on each and every site. Now, no broker, because owners and tenants are connecting with each other directly, so that high cost is taken care of. And third is an ancillary problem, which is, can you find a non-brokerage ecosystem which is not there on any of these sites. So what we basically came up with, that we should disrupt this market by offering a solution which connects owners and tenants directly. And there are many things which a broker does heuristically, which you can do far better in terms of technology. So for example, if you are searching for a flat in Bandra and your budget is a tad lower, so a broker may suggest to you that why don't you look at Khar? And perhaps if it's the same equidistant in terms of your office, perhaps you may want to stay in Khar. Or he may say, rightly or wrongly, that this property is going to go fast, or your rent is too high, or rent is too low. But those things have basically an angle of bias. If he has properties in Khar, he will show it to you. Otherwise, he will say this is what it is. Technology can solve it far better. So for example, what we do is, if you are an owner and you put your property on the side and you are getting a little greedy, so what you will do is, for 30,000 rent, you will put 35,000. What the system will immediately show you is, on a real-time basis, that you have had 120 views on your property, but barely 2 contacts. So you know that people are watching my property, but nobody is contacting me. So the matchmaking with the help of technology becomes far more transparent. So we basically came up with this concept that, can this be done? What we basically heard from people is, this cannot be done. So I'm sure many of the entrepreneurs who are in this room will echo with me that this is a tough part. When you start the business and you get both the parties, there are friends who would say this is a good idea. There are many friends who would say this is a good idea out of politeness, but actually they think it's a very bad idea. And there are investors who would, the way which investor would say no is, you get some traction and then we'll talk again. That's a polite way of saying no, instead of saying that we don't think this can work. But I think for us, what has worked is, we have always tried to see as to what is the customer saying. So although there was a dissonance in terms of what many of our friends said, customers were totally sure that brokers, for majority of the transactions, brokers are a deadweight loss. Of course, there are very good brokers who add value to the client, who make sure that they let a deal go, but they make sure that client is the best value. But they are a minority. Majority of the brokers are those who, after the 11th month has passed, they have never looked into your house, they have never visited you. At the 11th month, they are going to blackmail you to again pay 1 month of brokerage to enhance the transaction for next 11 months. So that's how it is. We basically, when we started our business, me and my co-founders, Akhil and Saurabh, we started putting 1,000 rupees every day on Facebook ads and Google AdWords. And we started getting 10 customers, 15 customers, 20 customers. And when we spoke to them, we realized that people do really want to connect with each other directly. And we could see as to how many Facebook groups are there where people are trying to say Facebook, Flatmate Facebook, PG Facebook, and so on. So there are many on Quikr, on different sites, people are putting in caps letter, no broker. But they were not, but there was no institutional platform. So we started working in late 2013. We launched in March 14. And from March 14 to December 14, we basically bootstrapped. We started seeing 5 customers, 10 customers, 20 customers. We got funded from SAF Partners late December in 14. And in the past 5-6 months, we have been able to grow very fast. So today, where do we stand? We are the world's largest ecosystem of genuine owners and tenants. As of now, this is July data, as of August, we have 2.5 lakh customers who are genuine owners and tenants, not a single broker on our platform. If you come to nobroker.com, post your property, we are in Bombay, Bangalore, Pune, Chennai, not even a single broker. Now, how do we do it? See, in India, when you're establishing a business, you cannot establish it based on general trust. So you can't say, the site is named nobroker.com, so brokers please don't register. brokers will fake themselves as owners or as tenants and they will try to register. So the first thing that basically me, Akhil and Saurabh, we did was to create an algorithm, which is our secret sauce, which basically scans the entire internet world, scans all the social media, scans, or we have digitized a lot of offline databases. If you're a broker, you would have given your visiting card to someone. You would have left some footprint and will capture that footprint and will catch hold of it. So if you come to our site, you can see all the properties, but you cannot contact any owner. You can post a property, but the property will not become live. Before that, we take up the algorithm takes basic details for registration. Algorithm works in the background and checks whether you are a broker or not. If you are a broker, or if brokers basically take a very jugadu approach in this and they give their wife's phone number and so on and so forth, which you see. So if you are a broker or you have a lot of broker connections, we are going to ban. So what we have done is, and this algorithm as of now is 99.9% effective. Once two brokers typically in a week are able to seep through the system and we are able to catch them within the next 3 or 4 hours, because some owner or tenant is going to report, hey, your site name says no broker. How come this guy is asking for a brokerage? So the community also acts as a watchdog in it. So what we have been able to achieve is basically 2 lakh customers. In these 4 cities, we have 63 new properties which have been posted till now. So a lot of owners and tenants have basically trusted on us. Every day we are closing 70 to 100 rental deals. Every day we get a lot of threatening calls from brokers because we are nibbling away their business in these cities. In terms of the owner listing, we have been able to beat all the top players. Housing Common Floor, 99 Acres, Magic Bricks. Rental market is a market which has been ignored by most of the players. They are focusing, rightly so, in the primary market, in the secondary sale. This rental market is something which customers, which main players have ignored. And this is the market that we have taken. So in both Bombay and Bangalore, every day the number of owner listings that we are getting is far, far more compared to any other player which is there in these cities. What we have basically made sure is, see, the fundamentals of a P2P in terms of unit economics is far different from a B2C business. For a P2P model, you need to be very capital efficient. You need to be very lean. Because every office boy who comes to your office and you give him 10,000 bucks, you have to take it from someone. And that someone is known as but a customer. You cannot basically ask a broker to pay it, right? Because it's a C2C community. So what we have made sure is that our algorithm works in the background. Any advice, anything, people in India still wants to have the comfort of calling. So if suppose people call us, if we send them an SMS saying this is the owner's phone number. By the way, we don't display the owner's phone number on the site because security issues. If you have given a phone number, we will only send the owner's phone number on a registered phone number. So people call us saying that, hey, I have been trying to contact this owner, but he's not picking up the phone. People call us for this also. And we give them comfort, don't worry, they have got your SMS. That guy might be in a meeting, he will call you back. So we have made sure that everything is through technology or through phone. There is not even a single person who is offline. So all our resources are based out of one city, Bangalore, in one building. For photos, we have taken a totally different approach. I think WhatsApp works like a charm in India. So people who are owners, who are little elder in terms of age, they are far, far comfortable on WhatsApp rather than internet. So if owner, because they are typically between 35 to 55, so not every owner comes to the site and gives a tale. Many of the owners just give us a missed call. And missed call is working great for us. So they give us a missed call, and just like you would give our details to a broker saying this is my detail of my property, we give them a call. A typical call is 2 to 2.5 minutes long. We take all the details. We ask them to send us the photo through WhatsApp, which we take, and we post the property. So we have made sure that the entire model, which is a P2P model, is very capital efficient and very scalable. In terms of the total market, when we started, we thought intuitively, yes, this seems to be a big market and brokers must be making money. But how much money, we had no idea. So what we did was, we basically took the government of India census data in terms of how many rentals are, flats are there in each city. Then we took the National Housing Board data in terms of what is the average rent in these cities. And we found that every year, 25,000 crore worth of brokerage, only in residential, only in rental, is being paid to the brokers. Brokers who are, most of them are half educated than perhaps most of us, and who had very little value, and who do this perhaps as a part-time activity, and who will threaten you in case you try to give them a single paisa less. These are the guys who are getting 25,000 crore worth of our common man's money because of this cartel which has been made in the system. And this market is growing by 25% every year. Can you believe it? That's why we see in every city, every lane, we see brokers which keep on coming up. Because it grows by unit, 13% more flats every year, and it grows by inflation also, 10% more value per flat. It keeps on growing. So, although we don't have time to go through the product, but what I will tell you is that how does a fundamentally a P2P product looks different from a B2C product. So if you go to any of the other sites, you will see that the home page will basically have a search criteria. Because they will say that you want to search a property. Because the listings are being given by broker, so they don't have any incentive to get the listing of own. Our site is equally divided because we want owners as badly as we want tenants. That's a fundamental difference. Then of course it talks about photos and details and hospitals that are close by and the map search. So what is important is that from every chain in this entire thing, right, from the point that you are owner and tenant discovers each other, meet each other, schedule the negotiation, make the rental agreement till the closure shifting, we have tried to identify what all does a broker do and can technology make it even better. For example, for scheduling, what we have done is, can we create a concept of an open house through technology? So as an owner, you might say Sunday 4 to 5 p.m. suits me better. So a scheduler will ask the tenants to basically come at that time. We'll try to bunch up all the tenants during that time so that we create an open house and the owner comes and he shows the properties to everyone at the same time. You want to create a rental agreement? Can you do it through net? This I will cover. So across each segment, we are trying to solve it through technology, and this is very, very doable, which is how our customers are accessing it. So one game changer which we are doing for Bombay, especially Bombay and Pune or Maharashtra, is that many of you would have registered your property for rent in the government office. So in Maharashtra, it's compulsory that you want to register an agreement, you need to go to the government office. You need to take a half day off, you need to stand in a queue, no matter how big or small guy you are. If a 10 o'clock appointment is given, you will perhaps end up at 12. And then you need to pay some 5,000 bucks to the broker, plus the government charges, and then after a few days, you will get the agreement. We have totally changed it. Now you just need to sit at home. It can be a Sunday. A guy will come. So what you can do is you can fill the entire rental agreement details over internet. You can make it as simple as you want or as complex as you want. And once those details are filled, a guy will come to your home. We have already seen. So we don't have any offline resources, but we have partnered with a vendor who has in turn partnered with the government, and the entire server syncs up with the government server. That guy will click a photo using his laptop, will use your Aadhaar card, will have a biometric device, and will check everything. And after 4 days, 3 or 4 working days, you will get the original printed government stamp rental agreement at your home. Nobody has done it in India. We are the first one to do it here, which basically proves that technology can solve all of these problems which brokers have magnified in terms of their real issue. Another interesting thing which we have done is that what we realize is that how do we keep on getting more and more owners? How do we reach out to those owners? So what happened is that in our office, one guy, see in Bangalore, this is not so prevalent in Bombay, but in Bangalore and Chennai, a lot of owners put this two-let board outside their house. What they mean to say is that my house is available for rent, and if anybody is passing by and notices it, perhaps you can come and deal with me directly. You don't need to go to a broker. We felt that can we just, some of our colleagues used to click those photos and bring it to us, and we used to cold call these owners and list on our site. We thought, can we do it more in a higher volume way? We thought, should we hire a couple of people who will go on the bike and who will click those photos? But then, because our principle is that we should not have any offline resource that limits our scalability, we thought, why don't we crowdsource it and give an opportunity for everyone to be a broker person? So what we have done through our app is that you are visiting any street, take a photo, which is a two-let board photo, upload it on our app, and we'll pay you 100 rupees in your Paytm account. And this has caught up like wildfire, so we have not advertised it at all, but still we are getting listing 100 properties per day only from Bangalore. the load is so much that we're not able to handle it, and we have slowed it down. We need to recruit more certificate processes, then we will advertise it. So such is the power of crowdsourcing, which we are, this is the first time that is happening in the country. Our customers are of different ages, owners are basically on the higher side, tenants have either young couples or people who have just bachelor's and just passed out, and so on and so forth. And everybody is, people, the common thing which people say about us is genuine. The single word which we hear most is that you guys are genuine. Whomever, otherwise earlier when the owner used to receive calls, most of the calls would be from brokers. Now you can be rest assured that I put my property on the site, I will only receive 4 or 5 calls. Those people would have already seen the photos, they would know what is the amount that I am charging. Without any bias, the details of the flat would have been shared with them. These 5 people will be really interested people. I need to choose one of them and go ahead. So I think that is the biggest thing that we hear from our customers. Few, as I told you 1 year back when we were talking about with investors, the common thing which came across is, who has done it in best? We couldn't give any big example of any company who has done it in best. And because in many of the things, the theme is to basically copy West, because if it has worked in West, the chances are high to work in East. And because we came up with something which has not been done in West, and there is a reason for it. There are so many regulatory arbitrages or obstacles which has been created in West that is taking time. But within this 1 year, what we have seen is there are so many players that have come up. So for example, I will tell you how UK works. In UK, as an owner, you have no way to list your property on a site. So the key sites are prime location, right move, and they allow only an agent or a firm to list the properties. So artificially you have made sure that you make money from one side. So what many of these firms are doing is that they are asking owners to list the properties on their site, and on their behalf they list the property on these sites, which they get tenants, and they try to save brokerage on one side. So now across the world, which is China, UK, US, P2P in real estate is catching up. And more firms are coming up, although there is no clear leader yet. But things have changed very quickly in the past 1 year. Our belief is that globally, across industry, P2P is a trend. Everybody, the chances are very less that you will earn a fat margin without really adding value. So if you ask us, of course, there will be some bit of brokers which will always be in the system because they really care about their client. But majority of the transactions are going to move from a B2C to a C2C. An online broker is going to be, from offline broker, the change to online broker has happened, which is very easy. Brokers using website.